This filament contains real diamonds. Yes, you heard me right, diamonds. It claims to have some real unique properties and not just aesthetic ones, so in today's video we'll perform an in-depth investigation to find out if it's worth buying. This material is called Ultra Diamond PLA Plus and is sold by the Dutch company Tiomet 3D and the Finnish company Carbodion that developed the technology to produce nanodiamonds. The filament is a composite material which uses PLA as the base polymer, in which the diamond particles are added in a way similar to carbon fiber filled plastics. If I speak of nanodiamonds, I don't mean the normal industrially produced diamonds that you find on your stone cutting saw blades, for example. The nanodiamonds, as the name already suggests, have a size below 1 micrometer and can, for example, be produced in impact events like explosions. There isn't a lot of information about them around, but they have very interesting potentials in engineering and medical applications. Tiomet and Carbodion have been putting them into 3D printing filament and claim that the resulting material can be printed extremely fast, is very stiff, won't wear out your nozzle, and has a high temperature resistance. Also, the thermal conductivity is apparently 3 times higher than standard PLA, which would make it interesting for a couple of mechanically challenging applications. If you want to get your hands on a sample of the material, stay until the end of the video and get a chance to win some. The filament is sold on 500 grams and 1 kilogram rolls and will set you back around 60 euros a kilogram. In my first test prints, I tuned the extrusion factor and settled with a slightly reduced value of 0.97 on my original Prusa i3 Mark 2.5. I tried fan settings between 0 and 100%, but due to the rapid crystallization of the material, actually even the prints without a cooling fan already looked really nice, and starting at 25%, there wasn't any difference to higher settings visible anymore. I still used a minimum of 50% cooling fan for the rest of the prints. In terms of nozzle temperature, I tried settings between 260 degrees Celsius down to 220 degrees Celsius. Besides slight changes in stringing, there wasn't any real difference on the temperature tower detectable. For the sake of layer adhesion, I compared 230 degrees Celsius to 250 degrees Celsius and decided to go all the way up to 250 degrees Celsius for the rest of the samples. In the quality test tower, the overhang performance was the best I've ever seen so far, and even the 75 degree slope looked great. Bridges were almost flawless, and even the largest 70 mm gap printed great. Only the stringing test didn't really look that good and showed quite a lot of hair and blobs on the surface. I have a slight feeling that moisture could be an issue, but I can't prove that at the moment. All of this is also represented in the 3D Benchy that has a nice, almost purple shine to it and looks great besides the small blobs and strings that you can see from time to time. If you pay that much, the outer appeal is most of the time something that is not the most important thing, so we'll now take a look at the mechanical performance. With a tensile strength of 56 MPa, it is not as strong as regular PLA, but on the other hand is way more ductile and yields quite a bit before it fails. Layer adhesion is the point where this material, in my opinion, is kind of bad, because the samples that were printed in the standing orientation all failed at around 15 MPa of stress, which is just a third of the normal strength. I don't know if this is the normal composite problem, or if the base resin they used with the fast crystallization is the reasons the layer don't bind very well. The material doesn't seem to degenerate during printing, because also the filament strength test showed an ultimate tensile strength of 56 MPa. One of the most interesting properties about this material is the stiffness that I tested using a bending test, where with a bending modulus of 4800 MPa, it is more than 50% stiffer than regular PLA and even stiffer than some carbon fiber filled materials. Unfortunately, this property is print direction dependent, and if you print a standing specimen, it is with a modulus of 3400 MPa, just a little bit stiffer than normal PLA. The reinforcing properties of the nanodiamonds seem to be similar to fiber-filled materials, so mostly only in print direction and not perpendicular to it. My test hooks confirmed the previous results, and with a failure load of 57 kg, it is slightly weaker than regular PLA, but stronger than many other materials. The hook that was printed standing also showed only weak layer adhesion and failed prematurely at 17 kg of load. The nano diamond PLA filament has an impact strength around twice the one of regular PLA, but still far away from ABS, for example. The impact strength of the standing coupons was similar to the tensile tests again, only around 1/4. Despite the bold claims, at least my material already softened at 55 degrees Celsius and then totally failed at 60 degrees Celsius, very similar to other PLA. This is where annealing comes into play. Ultra Diamond PLA Plus uses a composite of PLA that only minimally deforms during the annealing process, so parts don't warp during that procedure. I put a couple of test coupons in my oven at 100 degrees Celsius for around half an hour and then turned it off and let everything cool down naturally. This let the material crystallize and therefore making it more heat resistant and changed the mechanical properties a bit. These samples were able to bear around 140 degrees Celsius before they got unusable. The other test samples only showed minor changes in their mechanical properties, which is in my opinion not relevant. So in summary, I think that the material is really interesting and is, especially with its stiffness and lack of the nozzle wear problem, a real alternative for other fiber-filled materials. The print quality is really good, but the layer adhesion is kind of disappointing. Due to these reasons and the anisotropy in the stiffness requires you to properly orientate your part in a way that it takes full advantage of the benefits. The thermal conductivity and the lubricity of the nano diamonds could make this material a real interesting contestant for bearing or gear applications, especially if you anneal the parts. I talked to the guys at Tiomat3D and was told that they will continue working on the PLA composite and apply their nano diamond reinforcement also to other higher technical materials like nylons and polycarbonates. So look out for those! I still have some material left over that I want to give away, so if you want to win some filament, like the video, make sure to be subscribed and leave a comment down below that you want to win some filament and what you would print with it. I'll then pick a couple of random winners during the next days. I'd also like to know from the other viewers what they think about this filament. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video and learned something, and make sure to subscribe. The full set of test samples and the detailed test report is available for my Patreons, and if you want to support the making of these videos, please also consider to support me there. I hope to have you around in the next videos. Auf Wiedersehen and until next time!